Good morning, dear students. Welcome once again to the biology class. So let's begin with the class. As you all know, children, we are dealing with chapter 13, Why Do We Fall Ill? And in today's class, we will be discussing about two important topics, namely principles of treatment and principles of prevention. So let's begin with the class. So children, there are two ways to treat an infectious disease. One would be to reduce the effects of the disease, and the other is to kill the cause of the disease. For the first, we can provide treatment that will reduce the symptoms. The symptoms are usually because of inflammation. For example, we can take medicines that bring down fever, reduce pain or loose motions. We can take bed rest so that we can conserve our energy. This will enable us to have more of it available to focus on healing. But this kind of symptom-directed treatment by itself will not make the infecting microbe go away, and the disease will not be cured. For that, we need to be able to kill off the microbes. That is the second way. So, to kill the microbes, that is the second way of treatment, it can be done by taking suitable antibiotics and drugs which kills the microbes and the disease is cured. So now children, let's talk about the principles of prevention. There are two ways of prevention of infectious diseases. These are general ways and specific ways. So the first is general ways of prevention. The general ways of preventing infectious diseases mostly relate to preventing exposure. Public hygiene is the most important for prevention of infectious diseases. Proper and sufficient food for everyone will make people healthy to resist the infection. So, the specific ways of prevention, there are disease-specific measures which are used to fight against them. It is done by immunization. So children, immunization is the process of introducing a weakened pathogen inside the body of the host to fool his or her immune system to produce antibodies against that particular disease. Not only does our immune system fight the diseases, but also keeps a memory of the incident by keeping these antibodies in blood. Thus, next time, even if the disease will strike the host body with full vigor, the body will be able to protect itself with the help of these antibodies, which were produced with the help of vaccine. This is also the basic law followed by vaccination programs done for infants.
Thank you, Shemstars. That's all for today. You can drop your queries if you have any on the Google Classroom. Take care. God bless you all.